The cost of cooking gas expected to increase again in September. Regasco President Arnel T. expects an increase of as much as 22 pesos per 11-kilogram gas tank. This after LPG prices in the international market increased by more than $20 per metric ton. Cooking gas prices were also up by as much as 30 centavos per kilogram this month. On the other hand, oil prices will see a hefty rollback today, with diesel having the biggest cut of nearly 2 pesos. The Energy Department cites weaker demand for fuel worldwide and a stronger peso against the greenback for the rollback. The Philippine Agriculture Department targeting to reach 60 Kadiwa network to direct-to-consumer food stores by next month. Agriculture Chief Francisco T. Laurel Jr. says the administration is planning to expand the government-subsidized stores in the Visayas and Mindanao with a goal of having over 1,000 store network outlets. Kadiwa provides farm cooperatives and associations an opportunity to sell directly to consumers, maximizing their returns by cutting out the middlemen. The stores, which also feature the 29 peso per kilogram rice program, targeted at vulnerable segments of society. The DA is planning to invite food manufacturers to offer canned sardines, cooking oil, and condiments in Kadiwa stores. The Technical Education and Skills Development Authority poised to receive a higher budget next year. TESDA Director General Jose Francisco Benitez says all House lawmakers had supported the move to increase the agency's funds during Monday's budget deliberation. For 2024, TESDA has a budget of around 21 billion pesos with a net amount of 18 billion. For next year, it is pushing for enterprise-based training or programs that are developed within companies and firms, which is not included in the current budget. A new study reveals the impact social media influencers have on the buying decisions of Filipino millennials and Gen Z. A survey by technology website Unbox and public relations agency Ripple 8 shows that TikTok and Facebook are now the primary tools for product research, especially among younger users. The study titled Like, Follow, Buy surveyed 1,110 Filipinos aged 12 to 42. It found that 86% of respondents use social media channels for product reviews, surpassing traditional search engines and influence. Now, it also showed that influence played a critical role in shaping consumer behavior, with nearly 90% of respondents relying on influencers for reliable product information. The Philippine economy can grow up to 0.7% if idle funds from government-owned and controlled corporations are reallocated to other state programs and services. This, as the Finance Department reiterates, the reallocation will fund infrastructure and flood control projects, among others. According to the agency, that can translate to up to 24 billion pesos in tax revenues. It will also bring in around 600,000 additional jobs. The agency also again defending its move to transfer state health insurer PhilHealth's idle funds back to the national government as legal and ethical. So far, 30 billion of PhilHealth's nearly 90 billion pesos in idle funds have been remitted back to state coffers.
If hindi natin gagamitin no, itong unused funds ng PhilHealth o ng iba pang GOCC, ang mangyayari parang instead na gamitin natin kung ano na yun nandyan, mangungutang tayo. Or kailangan po natin magtaas ng buwis. Magtataas tayo ng buwis, yan, ramdam ng lahat yan. Magtataas ka ng VAT o income tax or magdadagdag tayo ng excise taxes, ramdam ng lahat yan. Pero on the other hand, kung hindi natin, kung mag-aano tayo, kung ang gagawin natin is we will use what is already there, hindi natin kailangan to look at taxes.
Now, the Philippine Central Bank shows off its 100,000 peso commemorative banknotes. The BSP says this is the largest Philippine commemorative banknote. It was first printed in 1998 to celebrate the centennial of Philippine independence. The BSP says the 100,000 peso banknote can be purchased as a collectible at the BSP store. Turning now to the crackdown on POGOs, the sister and cohort of dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Go now under the custody of lawmakers. Alice Go will be facing the Senate's probe on how her sister managed to flee the country, while Cassandra Lee Ong will appear before the House Quad Committee investigating illegal POGOs. The two spent days at the headquarters of the National Bureau of Investigation after being deported from Indonesia. Authorities maintain their detention was legal.
Walang warrant, walang kaso, ididetain mo sa NBI. That is arbitrary detention. Ano bang arbitrary detention? Any public officer who detains another, ha, without the legal cause. Oh, hindi ba yan, public officer, ha, mga NBI, dinetain nila si Cassie Leong at saka si Sheila Guo. Walang warrant, no nothing.
Walang arbitrary detention dito. Remember, ang arbitrary detention nagraran lamang pagka may office hour. Eh, holiday tayo magmula pa nung Biyernes eh. May process na ginawa kami at pinailan namin ang charges, criminal charges, and they have undergone inquest proceedings.
Meanwhile, the location of Alice Go is still unknown. She's believed to be staying in Indonesia and may be planning to go to other parts of Southeast Asia.
Yung mga ASEAN ambassadors na kausap ko at sabi nila naka-alerto na rin yung kanilang mga otoridad. So mahirapan siyang gumalaw ngayon sa ASEAN. Tingin ko mahuhuli siya sa Indonesia.
In other news, two more Mpox cases are detected in the Philippines. Authorities are still verifying a suspected case in the Visayas region. Now the details from Rafael Bosano.
The entrance of this club in Quezon City now closed and cordoned off. This after local government authorities served a cease and desist order and notice of violation to the establishment for refusing to cooperate with contact tracing and investigations of the local health department's epidemiology and surveillance division. In a statement, the QC government said it went to the establishment to carry out contact tracing activities due to the Mpox transmission. Mayor Joy Belmonte called the establishment's refusal to cooperate a threat to the health and welfare of the city's residents as it delays possible solutions to the health issue. On Monday, the Department of Health confirmed two new cases of Mpox, bringing the total number of cases in the country to 12 since 2022. Patients 11 and 12 are both men from Metro Manila. One of them is a 37-year-old whose symptoms appeared last August 20. Rashes manifested on his face, arms, legs, thorax, as well as his palms and soles. He says he had no exposure to a person with the same symptoms. However, he also admits having close, intimate skin-to-skin contact 3 weeks prior to the appearance of his symptoms. Skin samples from the patient were brought to the Research Institute for Tropical Medicine, which eventually yielded positive results. Meanwhile, patient 12 is a 32-year-old whose symptoms began to appear on August 14 through lesions in the groin area, face, forehead, and scalp. Like patient 11, he also admitted having close, intimate skin-to-skin contact with another person. Samples of his skin were taken last August 23. Both patients are infected with clade 2 of the Mpox virus, which is considered much milder than clade 1. Patient 12 is now under home isolation, while patient 11 remains in a hospital. Health Secretary Ted Herbosa says local transmission of Mpox continues to be observed in the Philippines, particularly in Metro Manila. He stressed that the virus is not airborne, but is transmitted through sexual intercourse and other forms of skin-to-skin contact. Meanwhile, contact tracing is also underway in Katagman, Northern Samar, after a patient suspected to be infected by the Mpox virus was brought to a provincial hospital on Saturday.
The patient is considered a suspect only, pero for confirmation pa siya. Naka-admit siya ngayon sa provincial hospital, naka-isolate siya rin sa aming negative pressure room.
The health department says it defers to the local government in terms of risk communication, but it also stresses that announcements should be based on scientific evidence as stipulated in RA 11332 or the Mandatory Reporting of Notifiable Diseases and Health Events of Public Concern Act.
And ang dami kasing mga ibang sakit na kamukha ng Mpox na hindi naman naka-emergency sa international tulad ng measles, shingles, herpes. So mas maganda, antayin muna natin ang test results kung magka-positive.
Domingo adds, the DOH is now looking into how it can speed up testing of samples called in provinces to ensure that all measures to curb transmissions will be fast and efficient. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
Chinese ships block Philippine vessels on a resupply mission near Escoda Shoal. The Philippine Defense Chief says incidents like this make it urgent for the country to boost its capability to deter armed attacks. We have this report.
Two Philippine Coast Guard vessels set sail at dawn Monday from Buliluyan Port in Palawan. The BRP Cape Engaño and BRP Cabra will conduct a resupply mission in the West Philippine Sea. They will bring food and water supplies to the BRP Teresa Magbanua stationed near the Escoda Shoal. A few hours into the mission, a large vessel of the Chinese People's Liberation Army with bow number 105 shadowed the two Philippine vessels. It was joined by another Chinese militia vessel. After a few hours, five more Chinese Coast Guard ships surrounded the two Philippine Coast Guard vessels. Among them was the Chinese Coast Guard vessel with bow number 3104, the same ship that rammed the BRP Cape Engaño last August 19th. Palawan District Commander Coast Guard Captain Dennis Labay said they maintained radio communication with the Chinese vessels so no untoward incident happened. They informed the Chinese that they are only conducting a resupply mission for the BRP Teresa Magbanua. Meanwhile, on the sidelines of the country's observance of National Heroes Day, Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro said Manila is now focused on strengthening its defense systems to deter an armed attack by China.
Let us deter an armed attack. That is the more important thing, and that is what I'm focused on doing. Everybody's too focused on armed attack. Let's make ourselves strong enough so that that does not happen.
Over the weekend, Chinese vessels rammed and fired a water cannon at a BFAR ship near Escoda Shoal. This comes after a Chinese jet fired multiple flares into the path of a Philippine aircraft conducting patrols on two separate incidents. The Philippine military, meanwhile, said it conducted a test of its own flares last week.
Over a dozen followers of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy arrested following a tense standoff with authorities in Davao City. Now, the city's mayor and the president's sister, meanwhile, slammed the operation, accusing police of using excessive force. Johnson Manabat reports.
The Davao City Police Office arrested 18 members of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ on Monday afternoon while removing a barricade along the diversion road of Davao City near Davao City Airport and KOJC compound. Before 3 p.m. Monday, the police gave Quiboloy supporters 10 minutes to peacefully leave the area to open the road to motorists. This ultimatum was ignored by KOJC members, prompting the police to give the third and last warning for the protesters to disperse. But KOJC members did not leave the road. This prompted the ground commander to instruct the anti-riot police to proceed with the dispersal. But the dispersal turned violent after KOJC members pushed back and threw chairs at the police. Other KOJC members, most of them wearing t-shirts covering their faces, threw an unknown liquid to the police.
Okay lang, trabaho lang naman namin to.
Around 4 p.m., authorities arrested 18 members of KOJC who are now facing obstruction of justice complaints.
Sabi nga natin, ayaw nating dumating tayo sa punto na magkakaroon ng sakitan. Pero what we can assure you, hindi po manggagaling sa PNP ang panggugulo. Hanggat maaari, gusto nating maging matahimik po yung dispersal.
The group's legal counsel says it will file countercharges against the police.
Amin pong hinihikayat ang PNP, and we are politely demanding from them to cease and desist from this operation because this is illegal. This has no basis under the law. Amin po sanang nire-request po si Mayor Baste Duterte to invoke his power under Section 17 of the Local Government Code of the Philippines, the General Welfare Clause.
Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte questions the police alleged use of excessive force against innocent citizens and their unauthorized occupation at the KOJC compound. He also asked the PNP how long they will stay at the KOJC property. Another legal counsel of the KOJC also criticized the PNP's operation.
Pag sinerch mo yung premises at hindi mo nakita yung tao, umalis ka na. Okay. Kung gusto mo, pulis ka naman, i-surveillance mo, maglagay ka ng mga tao sa harap. Pero for you to enter, hindi nyo nakita, di ka na umalis, hindi pwede yun naman. Sa ang planeta, legal yun.
Senator Aimee Marcos also condemned what she calls an excessive show of force, saying the deployment of 2,000 police personnel to raid the premises of an established religion is both unwarranted and unjustified. But Senate Deputy Minority Leader Risa Ontiveros blames Kibuloy, saying the situation would not have worsened if he just showed up at the Senate. She also reminded the PNP to ensure no violence is committed in the exercise of their mandate. The Commission on Human Rights urges both the police and Kingdom of Jesus Christ members to remain calm and follow the judicial process. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.